The department recognizes the importance of upskilling and reskilling to equip our teachers in delivering quality education to our learners, even in the unprecedented time of pandemic. Thus, this episode will share some of DepEd's proposed new education system for teachers. To start off, here with us today is DepEd Undersecretary for Human Resource and Organizational Development to discuss career progression. Let us now listen to this presentation.
A pleasant day to everyone. It is an honor and privilege to present to this Education Forum series the new career progression system for teachers. This is an avenue where the BHROD can share, after doing an extensive study, how the career advancement among teachers will unfold. Today, allow me to discuss our vision for teachers' career progression and to introduce how we intend to realize this vision. We in the department envision that not a single teacher should retire at teacher one. By allowing them to remain in the classroom while advancing their stature and compensation through a career path where career options between classroom teaching and school administration are adequately provided. The career advancement shall be based on the quality of teaching practice, and that promotion is self-paced. This vision became picturesque as relevant findings from studies conducted locally and globally. DepEd Teacher Workforce Study by PIDS, for instance, revealed that it takes a number of years before a teacher can reach a certain position or rank. Major findings of the study further showed that 92% of teachers occupy teacher 1 to teacher 3 items as the median years in service from teacher 1 to MT3 range from 4 years to 29 years. Another relevant finding from UNESCO shows that entry-level salaries of teachers in the Philippines is the highest among Asia-Pacific countries. The Philippines, however, ranks 4 after 15 years of service or experience. This means that the promotion in the Philippines is very slow as compared to neighboring countries. In similar vein, the report developed by Jared Guajardo in 2011, as published by the Save the Children, titled Teacher Motivation, Theoretical Framework, Situation Analysis of the Save the Children by Country Offices, and Recommended Strategies correlates a slow pace of promotion with teacher motivation and job satisfaction. This report also cited the most critical threats to teacher motivation as highlighted, particularly in the Philippines, two of which can be addressed through this career progression reform. The same report provided country-specific analysis and recommendations with approaches to improving motivation, workload as commensurate as much as possible with the 7 motivational supports. The teacher motivation study by Simeo Inotech and DepEd highlighted that with teachers aiming for career movement throughout their career, opportunities for career progression should be made a viable option for teachers, those who want to focus on classroom teaching in particular. This includes revising the teacher plantilla system to provide additional career progression steps for teachers and master teachers, to ensure high performing and experienced and expert teachers are retained within the system and provided with opportunities for professional growth and development. At first, the review on the career progression system for teachers was seen as a response to the long clamor for salary increase. However, after digging deeper into it, issues are even more saddening. Issues that are systemic, structural, and cultural. In particular, and must wait for someone to retire, to resign, or die before a higher item can be available for promotion. And even when they are already have the necessary qualifications for promotion. The career progression policy that we are proposing is to make reclassification as the sole means for promotion. In that way, we create opportunities for career advancement. In relation to what I mentioned earlier, a salary is not commensurate with their qualifications as coupled with additional tasks that are not supposed to be performed by teacher. And this greatly affected teacher morale and motivation to strive. One of the main goals of the career progression policy is to boost the morale of our teachers through a career advancement leading to a commensurate pay for a reasonable work. On the other hand, our business is education. And we don't want to just promote teachers for the sake of promoting. We also want to uphold excellence among them so that they can pass it into our learners. While we feature reclass here, we must rethink how we do reclass. We want to do away with credentialism. Master's degree or a tenure service does not guarantee a quality teacher. We must gauge it based on established professional standards for teacher quality, the PPST, through a merit or competency-based career progression of teachers. We can ensure that we can take care of our teachers' welfare and at the same time promote excellence in our schools. On being fiscally more viable, it has been known to us that an across-the-board salary increase is costly. With this proposal, we can assure that the government only invests on the promotion of qualified teachers. In addition, promotion through reclassification is also beneficial to the government's pocket. Instead of creating new higher teaching positions that can be applied for through natural vacancy, through reclass, the cost that the government will have to incur is increment from teacher's salary grade to a salary grade of the reclassified position. And along with this increased workload in the classroom, and few opportunities for advancement, which has been identified as part of the most crucial threats to teacher motivation, we can now say that with this proposal, progression will be addressed and our teachers will not really retire at teacher one. But how do we embed the professional standards into the life cycle of a teacher such that career path becomes clearer and options become viable? By establishing the professional standards of teacher quality and using these standards in the selection, hiring, and promotion of teachers, and in assessing their performance, in planning and providing professional development interventions, and in rewarding and incentivizing teachers, we could guarantee that the quality of our teachers in our classrooms are of high standards. But how do we ensure the quality of teaching in the schools? We encourage teachers to embrace and have the standards as a way of life. We set clear expectation from teachers along well-defined career stages of professional development from beginning to distinguished practice. Engage teachers to embrace ongoing professional learning for their professional development to enhance their own teaching. Provide a framework of uniform measures to assess teacher performance. Provide a basis for building public confidence and in support for the work of teachers. The PPST is a framework for teacher quality that is attuned with the demands of the Enhanced Basic Education Initiative, domestic and global developments, the changes in the education landscape in the 21st century, and the desire to contribute more effectively in the delivery of education and learning. But how does career advancement happen? With Sulong Edukalidad as an overarching framework for career progression proposal, this is to address the challenging of quality basic education. It covers teachers' upskilling and reskilling among other pillars such as curriculum review, improving learning environment, and stakeholders' engagement. Within the pillar of teachers' upskilling and reskilling, the main program of DepEd is the NAEP transformation, which seeks to strengthen the in-service professional development of teachers and school leaders. The transformation of NAEP involves the upgrade and expansion of its staffing complement and the integration of the in-service professional development program through a stringent recognition process of professional development courses, trainings, and activities. Complementing the professional development of teachers and school leaders, the career progression proposal seeks to provide career progression opportunities. The teacher life cycle begins, as you can see in the framework, in the pre-service. And currently, in partnership with the PNU Research Center for Teacher Quality, is encouraging in providing technical assistance to teacher education institutions in aligning their pre-service curriculum with the PPST, Career Stage 1, or the beginning teachers. Our goal is to ensure that all graduates of the pre-service meet and demonstrate professional standards for beginning teachers. We are also in coordination with PRC and urging them to review the board exam test objectives with the end goal that licensure examination for professional teachers are testing and validating the aspiring teachers' basic knowledge of the teaching practice which is expected of a beginning teacher. Upon entry to the teaching profession, our selection and hiring policy in DepEd is currently being revised to integrate the PPST, which means that we will be assessing future public school teachers based on professional standards aligned with the beginning career stage. After which, we assess and appraise their performance based on the PPST indicators. And we have been doing that since 2018. The teachers' IPCRFs are already PPST aligned. We endeavor to develop our teacher professionally through the provision of L&D interventions that will enable them to acquire the necessary competencies as they go up in the career line. We will subject our teachers as well to the teacher induction program, master teacher programs, among others, all of which aims to improve their teaching practices on the basis of professional standards. And later on, we will reward and incentivize teachers based on their demonstration of the desired competencies. In this presentation, I will show you how we envision to promote our teachers based on their achievement of PPST standards. Currently, teaching positions only include teacher 1, 2, 3, and master teacher 1, 2, 4. In this career progression system, the features of which is that there will be additional teaching position which will add more opportunities for promotion among teachers. This include teacher 4, teacher 5, teacher 6, teacher 7, and MT5. It is worthy to note that we have been working with DBM on this reform agenda, and in fact, both agencies agreed to elevate the revision of the system of career progression of teachers to the president. DepEd has already drafted an executive order to this effect. Nevertheless, an ongoing effort in Congress and in Senate is also being done with Senate bills authored by Senator Recto and Senator Revilla, and in Congress by Congressman Strike Revilla. The alignment of the career line with PPE stages is that it means that teacher would have to demonstrate the expected competency standards for them to be able to get promoted to the corresponding teacher promotion. The teacher progression also features the classification as the sole means of promotion. This means that a teacher need not to wait for natural vacancy to occur for them to get promoted to a higher position. As soon as the teachers possess and achieve the expected PPST indicators per teaching position, they could already apply for reclassification. It minimizes the teacher to move to central schools just to get promoted, meaning through reclass, teachers can progress in their career while staying in schools near these residences. This again has been taken up with DBM already. And in fact, we are in our submission of the draft of the crafting of the DBM DepEd joint circular for this purpose. The proposed career progression diverges at MT1 to classroom teaching and school administration career lines. This is to ensure that the specialized teachers and MTs and school heads come from a pool of highly proficient teachers. In this illustration, the teacher career diverges at Master Teacher 1, which means that the teacher is given a chance to choose between alternative career lines in the classroom teaching and school administration. However, if a teacher would choose between these career lines and they are able to exhibit the professional standards for highly proficient teachers, they can go between these two career lines. In terms of function, teachers 1 to 7 should concentrate on the teaching learning process and development towards greater proficiency and possible leadership roles, while MTs and school heads should take on instructional supervision and leadership roles. It is necessary that our NAEP and accredited teacher training service providers should plan and provide L&D interventions that target the expected competencies in career stages. The goal is to move teachers to the next career stage. So what happens to the head teacher? all other positions that are not in the master, teacher, and teacher nomenclature, except for principal, will be retitled into equivalent SGs in the single line career path. This is how single line career path and retitling of positions is proposed. By rationalizing into a single line career path, DepEd intends to avoid shifting to teaching and school administrative position as in the current practice. This is to ensure that teachers' progression to higher positions are developmental and in accordance with standards. On the choice of career path, take note that at the base of the career system are the teacher positions, teacher 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. A teacher may be promoted to MT1 position. He may choose to be promoted to MT2 or school principal position, subject to applicable qualifications and competency requirement and assessment. A teacher pursuing for promotion to master teacher 2 shall continue upwards in the classroom teaching career line, while adopting a career as a school principal shall continue upwards in the school administration career line. Switching of career line from classroom teaching to school administration and vice versa shall be allowed, provided that the individual seeking changes in career line meets all the necessary qualifications and expected competencies of the position being applied for in the career line. As earlier mentioned, individuals seeking change in career line meets all the necessary qualifications and as expected, competencies of the position being applied for in the career line, thus embedding the PPST to the proposed reclassification policy. Now, given those opportunities for career advancement, let us compare the current and proposed progression for teachers. How do teachers really get promoted? So currently, our teachers are promoted by two different modes. The natural vacancy, which the teacher has to wait for vacancy due to resignation, retirement, or death. And the reclassification, which is currently based on credentialism rather than competency-based attainment of academic preparation levels and experience as well as training. Under this proposal, reclassification will be the sole means of promotion. No more natural vacancies, as waiting for a natural vacancy wastes teacher capacity to take on bigger roles in schools. Reclass will allow us and our teachers to maximize potential and capacity, and that teacher will no longer have to compete with one another. They will now have to compete with themselves. They only need to beat at their last performance. And teachers can also get promoted at their own pace based on their achievement of teaching standards. And finally, teachers need not transfer to central school just to get promoted. However, reclassification shall be redefined to align the progression to higher teaching position with the achievement of the PPST indicators. The current policy is based on proxy indicators of competencies and credentialism, such as educational attainment, training hours, and years of experience. The current system assumes that as soon as the teachers acquire higher education, training, and experience, they already embody the desired competencies worthy of promotion. The proposed reclass policy will be based on the achievement of professional standards. So let us try to go over the steps for promotion. As reflected, there is a set of qualification standards for every position to amplify that professional standards are achieved. To become eligible for a classification, a teacher must satisfy the requirements as presented in the table based on defined career stages. And once teacher applicants meet the QS for the position, they must present their IPCRFs that showcase their proficiency in the indicators as appraised in their performance. And the table specifies the performance requirements for each position. In terms of the selection process, the reclassification criteria here as basis for the selection process is as well redefined. Upon identifying all the eligible applicants from step one, which is the qualification standards, and step two, which is on the submission of performance requirements, the eligible applicant shall undergo the selection process to be conducted by the Human Resource Merit Promotion and Selection Board in the school's division offices. The selection criteria is presented, and the HRMPSB shall rank the applicant based on the total score obtained and prepare a teacher for the competency reclassification list, which will then be submitted to DBM for approval subject to availability of funds. So as you can see here, all qualified applicants who have been ranked shall be provided with the result of their scores as obtained, and as mentioned, it should be submitted to DBM. The HRMPSB shall submit to the budget officer the comparative assessment result for reclassification, and with the budget cutoff of the SDO applications who were not accommodated or which were not accommodated in the current fiscal year shall be prioritized in the next budget year. But where are we now in terms of this career progression proposal? In the career progression roadmap, we are still on policy framework, and we have already, as mentioned, drafted the executive order and submitted, even prepared the DBM DepEd joint circular, the qualification standards, and DepEd reclass policy, and onward to phase one implementation for 2022. And to note as well, that in the phase one implementation, since the career progression is primarily anchored on PPST and RPMS, and since it requires a three-year cycle for a teacher to complete the 37 indicators, it will therefore take at least 3 years to move from one career stage to another. And during this period, we'll be able to gauge whether the system is working and identify possible areas for intervention and improvement. And we also take this as an opportunity to study as well whether it would be wise to inject another major change in the system, drawing further focus on school heads. When adequate funding is provided to ensure that there is enough master teachers and bolster the number of master teachers that can provide enough instructional supervision, looking forward to having a 1:5 master teacher to teacher ratio, and the teachers can remain in the teaching career line while advancing in stature and compensation, and teachers and principals complement each other and given equal prestige and recognition. School principals come from the pool of highly proficient master teachers. The PPSH is integrated in the HR systems, such as professional development and leadership programs, the RPMS, promotion and or reclassification, support and non-teaching positions are created in schools to relieve teachers and school heads of ancillary functions. Classroom teachers concentrate on teaching and learning process. Master teachers perform instructional supervision and technical assistance, and school principals concentrate on school management and operations. With all of that, we're looking at Sulong Idakalidad with Gurong Idakalidad. We look forward to having the career progression really implemented and operationalized. With all of that, thank you very much. Once again, a pleasant day to all. Thank you.